Hello everyone, today I am going to start chapter Basic Analytical Techniques. In the last chapter we talked about the analytical chemistry. Here we are going to talk about the techniques involved. So the first topic is purification of solids. A solid substance may contain two types of impurities. Number one, which are soluble in the same solvent as the main substance, and number two, which are not soluble in the same solvent as the main substance. The second kind of impurity can be easily separated by using suitable solvent to dissolve the main compound when the impurities will remain undissolved or insoluble and will be easily separated by filtration process. It is exactly equal the process where we used to separate the tea leaves from the decoction of tea or sand from mixture of sand and water. Filtration used to be carried out with the help of filter paper. You are seeing on the screen the diagram. And filter paper is placed in a funnel. The circular piece of filter paper is folded to form a cone and fitted inside the funnel. The funnel is fixed on the stand and the beaker is kept below it. The paper is made moist. The solution to be filtered is poured on the filter paper. Then the insoluble part remaining on the filter paper, which is called as residue, and the liquid collected in the beaker is called filtrate. Now, filtration under suction. When filtration is carried out using a vacuum pump, it is called as filtration under suction. It is faster and more efficient technique than simple filtration. The assembly consists of the thick wall conical flask, which is having a side arm. A flask is connected to the safety bottle by rubber tube through a side arm. The safety bottle is used to prevent sucking from the filtrate into the suction pump, and special porcelain funnel is called Buckner funnel, which is fitted on the conical flask with the help of rubber cork, as you are seeing in the diagram. The Buckner funnel has a porous circular bottom. A circular filter paper of correct size is placed on the circular porous bottom of the Buckner funnel, and the funnel is placed on the flask. It is moistened by some drops of water or maybe solvent also. Suction is created by starting the pump and the filtration is carried out. Crystals are collected on the filter paper and filtrate will be collected in the flask. Now, crystallization. When a crude solid is made of mainly one substance and has some impurities, it is purified by the process of crystallization. It used to be done in the four steps. Preparation of saturated solution is the first step. The second step is hot filtration. Third step is cooling the filtrate. And finally, the filtration process. In the first step, a saturated solution is a solution which cannot dissolve additional quantity of solute is prepared, and on doing so the main solute forms an almost a saturated solution, but the solution is not saturated with the respect to the soluble impurities as they are very small in the amount. The second step is hot filtration. The above solution will be filtered when it is hot. Undissolved impurities will get removed as a residue in this step. Then the filtrate will be cooled down. The hot filtrate is allowed to cool. Solubility of substance decreases with lowering of temperature. As the result, the filtrate becomes supersaturated and respect with respect to the main undissolved solute. As a result, the filtrate becomes supersaturated. I am repeating this point. With respect to the main dissolved solute, the excess quantity of dissolved solute comes out of the solution in the form of crystals. The dissolved impurities do not supersaturate it, as you know, they are small in amount, and these continue to stay in the solution in dissolved state even on cooling also. The separated crystals are there free from the soluble impurities also. The final step, filtration. The crystal of pure substance are separated by filtration process. The filtrate obtained is called mother liquor. Now, how to choose a solvent? The solvent to be used for crystallization must be having properties which should be, the compound to be crystallized should be at least or sparingly soluble in the solvent at room temperature but highly soluble at the high temperature. Second characteristic should be, the solvent should not react chemically with the compound to be purified. And the third would be, solvent should be volatile so that it can be removed easily. Example like water, ethyl alcohol, methyl alcohol, acetone, ether, generally used for as a solvent for crystallization process. Crystallization of common salt from impure sample, it is a simple example of crystallization process. Here we used to take the impure sodium chloride crystals, we used to form the saturated solution, and first we will filter the saturated hot solution, and finally on cooling we used to get gradually the crystals of sodium chloride, and soluble impurities also be removed. Impure copper sulfate can also be purified by crystallization process, and here we can use water as solvent. Similarly, other example is, benzoic acid can also be purified by crystallization process by taking water as solvent. Now, fractional crystallization. Two or more substances in a mixture can be separated by fractional crystallization process. It is a process where two or more soluble substances having widely different solubilities in the same solvent at room temperature are separated by crystallization process. Suppose a mixture of two solute A and B are dissolved in suitable hot solvent to prepare a saturated solution. A solution will be filtered to remove the dust particles, and now it will be allowed to cool. As the solution will cool down, the solute which is less soluble crystallizes first. The crystals are filtered, washed with the solute and dried up. The mother liquor is concentrated by evaporating the solvent, and the second solute crystallizes from the mother liquor. These crystals are filtered to obtain the separated and purified second component. This is how the fractional crystallization process used to be done for separating two or more compounds from the mixture. Thank you.